This is TWiT.
The first prescription video game for kids with ADHD. Did you know about this?
I didn't see know this. About this.
Yeah, Georgia, you work with ADHD kids, right?
I do.
It's called Endeavor RX from Akili Interactive, formerly Project Evo. It's prescribed as medicine for the kids between the ages of 8 and 12 with ADHD. It's an iPhone or iPad game. 7 years of clinical trials. 600 kids figuring out whether this game could actually make a difference. The answer is yes. One-third of kids treated with this game no longer had a measurable attention deficit on at least one measure of objective attention after playing the game for 25 minutes a day, 5 days a week for 4 weeks.
The only thing I have to ask is that kids with ADHD usually are very good and have a lot of good attention when they play the video game.
They're focused,
and if they're
yes.
interested in something, they also have a good amount of focus. They can actually be hyper-focused.
That's what I did, yes.
So I just don't, and again, I'm intrigued by it, and I think that would be wonderful if it could help them on a separate area. But I wonder if it is, and if it's that area. And if it's that area, I don't know if it would be as usable to being bored. Like, our school system has to be kind of overhauled. It hasn't really changed in a very long time, and it's dull. Like, to be able to sit there, you know, and just listen to someone maybe perhaps prattling on about something, which sometimes can happen, or, you know, they're not being able to move around. I don't know if that would be as helpful, but
right.
I'm going to look it up and see.
Yeah. I mean, and there's also the issue of if it takes 6 years to approve it, by then the technology is antiquated.
Yeah.
I mean,
I'm a little surprised because the FDA does have a fast track system acknowledging that technology can move faster than the approvals process. On the other hand, I'm glad to see that this is getting actual scrutiny as opposed to other solutions for ADHD and other syndromes that simply say, well, this sounds like it makes good sense. There was a very, very popular set of fonts that are supposedly good for people. I think it was for
dyslexia.
But then, if I recall correctly, subsequent follow-up studies didn't show any real improvement beyond.
It depends on the type of dyslexia as well, right?
Okay.
If it's bottom-heavy fonts, and so I am a little bit dyslexic, mostly with like numbers and names of things. If you ask me a name of something, I won't know. But I don't flip my letters. I can't really spell.
I don't know if this was self-prescribing, but when I was a teenager, and I definitely was ADD, maybe HD, but mostly ADD, I started playing chess, and I had that hyper-focus, which allowed me to sit and stare at a chessboard for 4 and 5 hours for long tournament games, and it was quite successful. I think it helped me a lot.
But chess would be, I think that would be very effective, because
yeah.
you have to be calm, you have to be paying attention, you have to pay attention to the other person. I know that neurofeedback, so they do neurofeedback where they you're not kind of hooked up to electrodes, and when you're working on being calm, you know, there's a plane, it's a video game, and there's a plane that's kind of, there's many different ones, but like, let's say there's a plane that you try to move up and down depending on your brainwaves, and you're working on becoming focused, becoming relaxed, being able to calm your mind down, and when it does, the plane flies straight.
Yep.
And so that helps build up that part of your brain. Doing anything that's kind of slower paced can also help that. And so maybe they're working on something that is similar to that.
It looks like a traditional Twitch game,
I like
to be honest with you.
It's not drug related.
Yeah, I agree. Let's not drug them.
Effort. Yeah. You know what I mean? It's something to try, and we'll see what's going on. I mean, we're talking about the scrutiny. I feel like they just fast-track pills to pop in people's mouths like it's
right.
nobody's business. And things like this will get more scrutiny on it. But I mean, again, I'm just happy for the effort. If it works out, great. If it doesn't, no harm, no fail. I don't
yeah.
know about
yeah.
it. That's
yeah.
a thing or not.
Chess.
It's
try chess. And the thing is, I wasn't that's playing great. Speed chess. I was playing tournament chess, which meant literally it's 2.5 hours per person per game. So it's a long time. And the other thing it taught me is impulse control, because you're going to lose real fast if you can't sit on your hands and
right.
make sure that that's the right move.
Is that where you got the essence with that picture that I showed for your basis?
That's me
for
playing chess
you
right there.
You look very zen.
I'm
does
playing,
look really zen, though, in
I'm,
the picture.
I'm playing chess right there, as a matter of fact.
He practiced for TWiT in 3-hour episodes as a child.
Yeah, these long episodes. These are short for me.
It's nothing.
When I work with kids that are ADD or ADHD, I often do focusing exercises where you have to sit still like a statue. It's good for everyone, actually. It increases everyone's focus. And you have to do your breathing and you calm breathe, but you have to stay still. And we just work on staying still while I try to make funny noises or poke them.
Oh, that's fun.
So that they have to be able to be controlled. And then we play another game that I call Ninja. And I know, Owen, as we spoke about, ninjas are awesome. Play game Ninja, where you have to move very slowly to be able to, like, grab the treasure. And you can't make any noise. And if you noise, I am the samurai and I will come around and I will see you. And then we send you back to the beginning. And so it works on that self-control. And so those kind of things are very helpful if you have a child or you yourself are dealing with ADHD, to be able to increase that ability to stretch out your concentration when you're not really as interested in what you're dealing with.
That makes sense. That sounds like a good treatment.